The theme for swallowing awareness in 2023 is dysphagia, a difficult diagnosis to swallow.
Dysphagia is a medical word that means difficulty swallowing, and it can present in lots of different ways. People can have difficulty putting food in their mouth, holding food in their mouth, chewing, moving food or drinks to the back of the mouth, and then making sure that food or drinks go down the right way and not into the airway. People who have difficulty swallowing may have food or drink falling from their mouth, they may cough or gag when they're eating and drinking, they may take really long time to eat a meal, or may get really tired during a mealtime as well. I guess the main risk is that people might have food or fluids going down the wrong way, which can go into a person's chest and make them unwell with pneumonia. A speech pathologist's role is to work with clients who have difficulty swallowing to ensure that mealtimes are safe and enjoyable and that all nutrition and hydration needs are met. Jane, why don't you tell us a little bit about how you work with children who have difficulty swallowing?
So children who have difficulty swallowing, it can come from a medical reason, they may have been born with it, or it can be developmental where they just haven't learnt how to manage different textures. So our role is to make sure that we introduce foods in a way the children can manage them in a way that develops skills and their swallowing potential without putting them at risk of things going down the wrong way and making them feel distressed. We can do mealtime management plans, work in schools, work with dietitians and OTs to make sure that we're doing this all together with our families.
What about with adults? What do we do with adults?
Well, it's quite similar with adults, but we're looking at someone who is older. They may already know how to swallow and they've got a disease that's affecting it. So we may change things, give them some skill building therapy. The other things we might try to do with adults is work with the local hospitals and conduct video fluoroscopy assessments just to make sure that we aren't aspirating or to make better, more refined diet modifications.
Like the theme suggests, swallowing disorders can be difficult to diagnose, so it is always important you have a speech pathologist working with you to diagnose and help you manage your swallowing difficulties.
At ORS, we have a complement of very skilled staff in the area of swallowing management, and we work incredibly hard with our clients and their family to make sure that we address this serious issue.
If you or someone you care about has difficulty swallowing, please contact a speech pathologist to discuss this further.